We, and you should know this about people for whom you are auditioning, we want you to do well. Anybody for whom you're auditioning is hoping that you will do well because they want you to be the one that they're looking for. That's true of any audition. Nobody ever in an audition wishes you ill. They're always looking for you to do the best, and you will do your best. So you shouldn't be uptight about this. You're coming in here to sing for people who want the best for you or from you. Okay? Try not to psych anybody else out in the room. People have their own way of dealing with pre-audition nerves.
Also, if you don't do major interviews with you as you sing, don't analyze it.
Yeah, don't analyze what we're doing. We may talk to some people longer than we do others for various reasons. It may mean anything. Okay? Thank you. You can go to the band room and tell Mr. O we're ready for him, and we should be here for
pardon my saying, I told you so. You
need all my threshold, and don't be as big as a lump. And you'll set me on my feet, and you'll set me on your feet.
He's already cute without
sound.
Here I am. I'm telling you, when she called you here, and she made you do it.
Did she do that to you?
Not happy?
We're going to audition for the non-singing roles first. We'll then call back to the end of the evening. You can sit there and stew about it, or actually some of you need to be auditioning for some other things. I think you need to think about that first before you do it.
Okay. We're all going to be in here?
Yeah. We're going to do scenes. Here is because we care, and we care about this show, and we care about making you a part of it. And hopefully, even if you're disappointed with the other casting, you will not remove your name from the show list just because you missed with us.
It's kind of an impossible situation because if you look at the number of roles, you look at the number of people in the room, you know, it's just the numbers don't match. So it's unfortunate, and don't think that we don't sit up here thinking, oh man, I'd really like so-and-so to do this role or some role. And it's putting together a jigsaw puzzle, and it's really very difficult because if you look at one person, you say, well, this person's perfect for this role, but if we cast them there, then who would have done this role? So we really need them more there than we do here, even though they could do either. Hey, it gets to be very complicated. So have fun for the evening.
Keep away from him, that's all. Or I'll get the cops after you.
Common woman.
Yeah, I've called names, but I got him back just the same. And you're through.
Go put a new coat of paint on. He's starting to peel. Pleasure, boo. Get up, Billy.
I'm sorry.
No, that was funny. What is this? And who are you?
Never mind who I am. Bigelow, yes.
Where am I?
You're in the backyard of heaven, and the gates are over there.
The pearly gate?
No. These are the pearly gates are in the front. These are the just the mother of pearly gates.
I don't want to go.
Well, ain't you gonna wish us luck?
Carrie, of course I wish you luck.
Well, go ahead. You can kiss Enoch, too. Us being such good friends and me looking on, Asher.
What's the matter?
It's me.
Well, then you can go home.
Well, I don't want to go home now.
Well, then suppose I go away and leave you sitting here.
Even then, I wouldn't go home.
Do you know what you remind me of? A girl I knew in Coney Island. I'll tell you how I met her.
Thank you. All over but the...
The
dealing of the cards, yeah.
The easy parts
over. You guys can go home and go to sleep.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Some of the hardest work you have ever done in your life. However, the end result will be a memory that you will have forever. And there are kids who've done these shows for the past 3 years who, for some reason, even through all the pain and agony and torture, keep doing it. And it is sometimes painful, and it is sometimes agonizing, and it is always, almost always, fun.
Are you cooking the ice cream?
Roasting the lemon?
Thank you.
about what we're doing today? Some of you are liable to say, I'm wasting my time. And you're going to have to waste a little time today. We have to fit a bunch of action into a bunch of music and make it look like everybody is on the stage having a wonderful time. And I've blocked out a couple of hours, 3 hours. I blocked out a good 2.5 hours to get this done. If we get it done early, we may be able to do something else. If we don't, we may go to 5:30 trying to make this scene look right. I think the best thing for me to do is to read to you the action of the scene. And then we have to cast some roles. This scene is done in time. Because we can't wait till tomorrow to do this.
What's it called?
A sailor. And I want somebody not as big as Kevin. Aaron, stand up. Kevin, stand up. Go back there and stand up, son. Can you look, can you cower over him a little?
Not really.
Put your hands on your hips and pull your chest up.
I have boots on, by the way.
Aaron, would you fight somebody that big?
Yeah. Yeah, I can do it. I'm just like, okay.
This is a really scary thing for me to try to put together. Because I have no lines. I have, you know, we're going to try to make this work. If you know where you're supposed to be,
she's going to dish you big time when I get back. Oh, this is where you were supposed to land it, Julie. And then you're going to get on the carousel. Stay busy, everyone, okay? Find it. Everything needs to be moving. Keep moving.
You'll turn in place. and go, you will. She'll turn the place and go down on 7-8. You will do your forward roll. No, you'll have to do your forward roll on those counts. Forward roll on those counts. Girls, you'll come right in at the pose. You guys will walk on 7-8 and pick her up, and you guys will jump on them on 7-8. She's the only one that will do the spin. And down, okay? Diamond, ready? 4, 5, 6, 7, shall say. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. Diamond two, get in there, boys. Go, roll. Ready? And hit. Now. We can't hold it.
I wanted you to see the big kids that you're going to be working with in the dance that you're going to do, that you're going to be in. And really what you're going to be doing in that number is what Ian showed you, as well as, did you show them about turning and stuff?
Because we weren't sure what we were doing.
Right, okay. There are going to be some times that you'll all turn the same direction and stand, and just you'll do what everybody else does, so everybody's doing the same thing. Except maybe Veronica.
The kids... they're really great to work with because they've never really done a show before. I don't think anyway. They've never really done a show before, and so they're very excited, and they're always eager to do. You know, to do what has to be done, and you know they're easier to work with in that way. But it's also difficult at times because they don't take stage directions and. You know, choreography as easily as the high school kids.
I want to see you hop. Just try something. Hop. Can you do that? Who can do it? Mommy. Yeah, I would need mommy then too. Come back. Try it again. Try it again.
You're going to work on orchestra number 4. And we just, one more picture of you guys before we go on.
I don't know, it's just, when you say 4.5 weeks.
Yeah, it's like that.
It seems real close.
I vaguely remember that last year, like 5 weeks. I said, what? It was my first year, but see, I didn't know what to expect. That's why I wasn't really all that nervous.
Well, I think you can expect to see the set really develop.
That's what scares me.
Yeah. I know that scares you, because you see that you're ready, and but... Your house is going to be built this weekend.
Or fell that cells you glue.
Well, President of the United States, that'd be all right too.
If his mother like that, would be president unless he wanted to be.
Not Bill. My boy Bill, he'll be tall and as tough as a tree. Will Bill,
you know.
Like a tree, he'll grow with his head held high.
I think everybody knows how I feel about her. She's like a second mother to me. She's really brought about my talents. She's helped me a lot. I don't know what I would do without her.
Miss D is an absolute professional. She's so talented and
so many aspects, like music and acting and things like that. And I thank Miss D for teaching me so much through these 3 years. And I think I'll take what she's taught me and take it further.
If you already hate me, fine. If you don't yet, you will. And I don't mind, because you don't have to like me. I don't care. I can make this show look good anyway. Okay? Entrances will be made on time. You will not make a late entrance. If you are late for your entrance, don't come on stage. See, I have a great deal of respect for all of you that have chosen to do this on your free time. This thing that you're doing for fun, I do to pay my mortgage every month. So I make a living at it, and I'm really good. You won't meet anyone better at theater than me. I am by far the best actor you will have ever met. When it comes to running a show, no one does it cleaner than I do.
Jim is a unique character. He's not as bad as people claim to make him out. But he's a perfectionist, and he loves what he does. And since he does love what he does, he strives for perfection when he does it.
The time for you will be 10 to 20 years in prison.
Oh, no, it won't.
Raise your hand. You're going to raise your hand to ask the audience if it's okay if you start again or ask them a question, because they're not going to answer. You broke his moment. He just did a lot of work to get to that point. Now I have to see it again because it's got to do the whole thing. Has to happen over again.
You're Mr. Baskin. Is that one of your girls?
One of my girls?
If you could use one word to describe Jim, what would it be?
Teddy bear.
He's really deep.
I'd have to say manly.
B.
One word? Sexy.
He's just amazing. I really are. There are no words to describe Jim Demonic.
Okay.
Ask a question.
Why ain't you working?
I don't feel so good. Now take it.
It's maybe the clams not setting so good on your stomach.
Yeah, it could be. Maybe it was something. I was thinking maybe it was more something on my head. So. Okay. As soon as you got her, you're set.
So just keep on the call, you know.
Yeah. So she gets the idea.
Why ain't you working?
Keep your head up. Let me see it.
I don't feel so good.
It's maybe the clams not setting so good on your stomach.
Oh, it's nothing on my stomach. It's something on my mind.
kind of.
Then you're gonna turn. That's it. Just like that. Now cock back again. That's it. Now it's gonna be up. And then he's gonna take you down here like that. Okay. Watch your hand. You start the step. Because even if he misses, put your hand on my shoulder. Because even if he misses, you can still back away. You never have to touch him on the first time. Okay?
Yeah.
I mean, it's a complete surprise. Try one more time. Ready? Go. And then just move him out of the way. Because, yeah. And you turn around. Don't let that second leg go. Okay? Watch me one time.
Suggestion of these things. But that's what we're used to too.
Yes.
That it's possible to get that feeling, you know, when we open it and they don't know what to expect and the curtain opens and there's this thing that smells like a carousel and sounds like a carousel and feels like a carousel, but it ain't. And just that sort of surprise, that surreality, and then sets up the thing for the rest of the play where a grove of trees suggests a grove of trees, but they ain't. You know, and the house suggests the house, and the emphasis becomes more on the atmosphere and the actors.
He wants to see the scenery, okay? The house, you are going to imagine, the audience is going to imagine, that the house is filled in, okay? There's this space right here, and probably it will be filled in all the way down. So the people who come through the door here, and you may not come through here or here or here because that's real house, you can only come through here. When you come through here, if you don't want to be seen by the audience, you have to stand behind this panel right here. If you're anyplace else, you will be seen by the audience. So anybody that comes into this house has to stand behind this panel in order not to be seen, so you can understand why we cannot have a lot of people standing back there. Okay? In addition, he's considering this a kind of a root cellar. I'm not sure exactly how he's putting this on the house. I think it's kind of like this. And let me have that other little deal. I think it goes, no, over to, like in there, back it up a little bit and turn it. Sort of like that. Okay? There's a step up onto here. Some of you, once we get this.
Upside down.
Okay, the frame goes to the top, the frame goes to the top, right?
Yes, that's what, okay. I was doing.
You got me down here?
Yeah, you're in the hot spot.
Huh?
You're in the hot spot.
Lock it.
So you sure, like, you still can't, like, point off stage and go, ooh, look at the carousel? Are you sure?
Probably not.
You sure?
Probably not.
I don't know, you know, if these actors were any kind of actors.
But if we don't have a carousel in a couple of days, we're going to do another show.
You go, Chuck.
Little
rounds of sadness. Can I take these out of here? Can I take those out? Just leave them there. Hey, now I'm trying to. understand you didn't hear him. Sing it, Dan. You're a terrorist.
I want to get an idea of what your machine will look like.
That's the how much room you have. Yes or no? Okay. What do you say about me, Butch?
You put a lot on.
I thought I did, but she said it was all right, so who am I to blow a good
one? Oh, my.
It's going to be a pinch fest. It's going to fall off.
No!
It's going to be a pinch.
Did everybody bring me enough to make up the show?
She did not put it here.
Yes.
So
did
you?
Did
you? Get all of
my yeah.
Stuff.
Yeah,
I know. I don't have any clothes that go up that high.
Skin blotching. Michael Jackson, skin blotching.
You look like a tax collector, Scott.
Yeah.
Pass this through the
pass of each show and touch each person with it and take some of their energy and give them the energy from the shows of the past. And if you look as I come around to you and touch you with the magic wand, you might find your little sparkle in there. Pick one out for you. There are lots of them in there. Find yourself in here and feel the energy of me and of everybody who's been here for the last 10 years. Take what you need and give some back.
One of the really neat things is that you will never experience a rush quite like what you get at the end of the show when you walk out of the first call.
This is a very exciting time. What I want you to think about for just a moment are the people that got you there to get the applause because they don't get it. The person I guess I would like you most to think about while you're out there at one point or another, even if it's for one moment while you're out there, and you hear applause, is the only person that I have yet to meet in the theater, and trust me, if we went by and we added up all the shows all of you have ever done, I was at that point probably 10 years ago in my career, so it's doubled since then. I've done lots of shows. And I like it. I've never met anyone in the theater, but I thought this was good to me. Except for my wife. She's the only person that I think. I don't know. In to a large extent, probably the majority of what I know about how to work with people know I don't have a great bedside manner. I still make things happen. And I think that it is quite an honor every time I get to walk into a theater with her. And you will all find out your future. It's one of those parent things when they all say, you'll see it someday when you grow up. I promise you, in the years to come, you will remember. Think about it now. She doesn't get to go out there either when it comes to battle time. And trust me when I tell you, she has spent her nights crying herself to sleep over wanting this thing to go well. She does it every year. And every year I want to know why, and she doesn't know, she does it anyway. She's the reason I come here. I mean, I love working with you guys. I really do. I know it doesn't always seem like that, but I really do. But I do it because I get a rush out of watching her work. She's taught me more about teaching than anyone I've ever known. And she's taught me more about learning than anyone I've ever known. I don't want to make you to appreciate her because I know you do. But take a moment and acknowledge her. It is an honor that you will be aware of in the years to come.
The magic is you. Now is your time. This is it. We've been working through this. This is your time to share your magic. So do it. Doc?
This gets a little philosophical with this opinion on the theater. Theater is a living experience. It is self-destructive in nature because it exists for the moment that it's alive and it's gone forever. What's going on right now in this circle will never happen again. Tomorrow, when you come back to this circle and do this again, you will be 24 hours older. That may not seem like a great big deal, but in that 24 hours, each of those hours has 60 minutes, each of those minutes 60 seconds. Yet the human heart beats on an average of once per second, which means tomorrow night at this time, you will be approximately 86,400 heartbeats older, and you can't have one back. All the things you could have chosen to do, you chose to be here. I would like you to share some of those heartbeats with an audience because that's what the theater is about. The purpose of all art is communication. Ladies and gentlemen, places, act one, scene one, let's rock and roll.
Let's go. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Franklin High School's spring musical production of Carousel. The taking of flash pictures is strictly prohibited as it is distracting and may be harmful to the performers. By order of the Franklin Township Fire Marshal's Office, there's no smoking permitted anywhere inside the building. Please note the fire exits, stage left and right, and in the rear of the auditorium. We ask that you remain seated during the entire performance. If you must leave, please do so between scenes. During intermission, refreshments will be served in the cafeteria. Food and beverages are not allowed inside the auditorium, and the choir parents are selling t-shirts, buttons, and other show memorabilia. Thank you and enjoy the performance.
Thank you.
Dick, Julie's gonna have a baby.
Yeah, what about it?
Nothing.
My mother had a baby once. My little girl.
I gotta get ready before she comes. I gotta make certain that she won't be dragged up and slumped with a lot of folks like me. She's gonna be sheltered and fed and dressed with the best that money can buy. I never knew how to get money.
Okay. Looking good so far. You have anything you... Yes, you're thrusting your head. And it makes your voice get raspy on you. And that's what's going to make your throat sore. You're going to wake up with sore throat. Keep your head up on that. You, I'm losing the last word of every one of your sentences. Just get that last word out. The energy's really good, and they're getting your jokes, and they're getting all of the physical stuff you're doing. Just make sure you keep the energy through that last.
This is the way firemen carry people.
Is it?
See how helpless you can make a fellow feel if he gets fresh with you?
Mr. Craven, hello, Enoch. This is the way firemen carry people.
Where's the fire?
Here we go.
Excuse me, sir. Could you please tell me the time?
Drop the knife. Ahoy there in the Nancy B.
Ahoy! Who's down there?
Stop, bro, shoot! You file that one up, Maple Seed. I'll keep this one covered. There's another boat in here. Don't forget that. You look behind you. What do you see coming? Two policemen. You ask me what time it was? I'll tell you the time. The time for you will be 10 to 20 years in prison.
Oh, no, you're not going to send me to prison.
Who fired that shot?
What's going on here?
What do you think you're doing? Julie! Get up, Billy! Huh? Get up! Who are you? Shake yourself up. We gotta get going.
Going? Where are we going?
Never mind where. The important thing is, you can't stay here.
Julie!
She can't hear you.
Well, who decided that?
You did. When you killed yourself.
I see. So it's all over?
It isn't as simple as that. As long as there is one person on earth who remembers you, it isn't over.
Well, what are you gonna do to me?
I ain't gonna do anything. I just came down to fetch you, take you up to the judge.
Well, where am I?
Why,
you're in the backyard of heaven. There are the gates over there. The pearly gates. Nope, pearly gates are in front. These are the back gates. This is Mother Pearly. Why don't you go back down to Earth for a day like I said you could? Do something real fine for someone.
Now, what could I do?
Well, could do your daughter some good. Daughter? You mean my little baby's a girl? She's a girl! I just want to give you something.
What's that?
It's a star.
Go away!
Please, I want you to have this.
No, no, let go of my arm!
Please, darling, take
it. No!
I gotta see your graduation.
All right, Billy. Come with me.
We just keep your faith and courage and you'll come out all right. It's like an old song we used to sing when I was a boy in school. When you walk through a storm, keep your chin up high.